Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Titancraft. This is Light, and today we're going to do a little bit things a little bit different. You can see there's some Christmas gifts around, and yeah, we're right around Christmas, and I wanted to show off. Finally, got replay to work around my different farms, so yeah, here we can go over. So I finally got it to where I can take a replay of using this farm, so we're going to send this video off first with a nice replay of all these farms working, and then head on over to a couple other projects we've been working on. So yeah, guys, enjoy. We're back over here and just getting some more wood. Been doing so much stuff the last few weeks. Let's see, can I actually? I can. I haven't been AFKing over here this much, and getting to the point that I need a bunch of wood and I just don't have it. So been over here the last, I want to say 8 hours so far. And I've still got more to do, but let's see. Yeah, we'll just leave that going there. But yeah, it's been pretty good. It actually hasn't broke down in a little while, but it is actually Christmas Day, as you can tell by the chests all being presents. Yeah, it's been going good. And let's see, with the birch, we have almost 3 double chests, and I just did oak for about 3-4 hours too, so looks like maybe about a little under a double chest an hour. Maybe, well, we got these 5 hoppers behind there. But since it is Christmas now, let's see. Yeah, I can get there with 21. We got these books. It got Santa's emergency box. It contains all this stuff. Yeah. Yeah, so yeah, it was for Santa, but he should actually be on his way home. But yeah, so I got a bunch of cookies, some rockets, which I'm going to actually take some of those right now, pumpkin pie, golden carrots, and mending unbreaking silk touch, and cakes. I haven't actually made a cake this season, so that'll be fun to have some cakes lying around here. I need to start just putting cakes around. But yeah, we need to go. I actually signed up for Secret Santa, but you know me and my fun recording that I never record. I'm awful at recording. So we actually signed up for Secret Santa, and I actually forgot to sign the book, so it didn't get saved. So Grifter, one of the mods, had to make me a book for it. But let's see, let's go to the shopping district portal here. But yeah, so we've been actually out here working on this thing a lot over at the Christmas tree. But I just haven't been recording. I was going to do the replay of the live stream and Chungstar not loading in. But let's see, let me get around this way. But yeah, the Christmas tree got built in Creative. I helped over, and then Gretter brought it into the world here. But like this little thing right here, actually Tango and I did a live stream last week on getting this done. It was a short one, did about an hour. I put some of these up. Let's see, can't really see. I think I did like that, or yeah, I did some pretty bad ones. But yeah, so Tango built this little, it's supposed to be a little lava kraken, and then different people have come around, put more Christmas ornaments up. It looks like someone put candles. That's amazing. And then I came over here and put this ladder up. Hopefully I can show a short time lapse right here, if I can remember to show me making the ladder. And then Kintsugi brought in Tango and Mrs. Tango from our Creative world. And oh my gosh, they're after me. They're after me. They're somewhere over there. I probably need to sleep. Let me run out here and sleep. Right by the candy cane shulker. Yeah, this is all the supplies for this area. If you've left some of the supplies out here, anybody that watching this, you could now come over and claim it, pick it back up, because yeah, it's Christmas Day. But let's come over here. I believe this one right here. Aha, this is mine. So yeah, we did Secret Santa, and let's see what is inside this thing. Oh my gosh. Got We got a donkey. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yep. Let's see. Okay. I'll let you guys read over this. I will speed along this part. Oh my gosh, guys. Okay. So it looks like this is not going to be a hasty adventure here. Okay. All right. Let me clear my inventory. All right. So I've cleared my inventory. Let's get on Pluto here. Let's get all this amazingness out of here. And let's... Oh, okay. I cannot horse, apparently. Alright. Let's put on this amazing leather. This is gonna be fun. I can already tell. Okay. Oh my gosh. I didn't even get a sword. Oh, okay. So this is water. Okay, so we'll put that there. So apparently I gotta go find everything I need. Oh no, I don't want to lead you. I'm sorry. All right, so X marks the spot. This is great, because yeah, I'm amazing at maps. So yeah, let's go try to find out where this thing even is. Thank you. was traveling in the overworld and realized I wasn't finding it. So I came through the portal here. Pluto's dead. I killed him. Alright, so apparently we're going to be taking the rest of this journey on foot, and I have no idea how to read maps. So yeah, this is going to be a fun adventure. Let me go back to spawn and start this over. So yeah, we'll be back, and I'll try to figure this map thing out. Alright guys, so after a little bit of research and a little bit of me not even thinking, somebody sent me something a few days ago, and I didn't think anything about it until today. So yeah, I think, wrong button. Okay, that. I think I can take these off and Indiana light. Yeah. So kind of deducing that, and this guy lives in a desert area. Yeah, okay. So we're finally on the little white dot. Apparently on regular maps it only shows up 300 blocks away or 320 blocks away. So yeah, that was oh, am I going the wrong way? I guess I am going the wrong way. Okay, let's go this way. Yeah, so I'm very noobish against maps right now, I guess, but since I don't want to really be, you know, copyrighted or anything like that, it would have been amazing to have the horse or the donkey with me and riding across the desert, but apparently I can't do that. Okay. I was supposed to be building a storage system in this episode, and I've done everything but a storage system. So, okay, let's see. So that's south, that's east, that's north. So it's actually going to be this way? Is it straight this way? Yeah, okay. Because the top of the map is north, so yeah, I need to get swim Indiana light. Yeah, so we will have to start working on the storage area next episode, because this took a little bit of time, and I've also got a few other clips I want to show when I actually get done with present finding. So yeah, let me look for that, and then I'll show. Oh, what's this? Okay, so I think this was supposed to be the little dot resting place, and oh great, this is this seems like, okay. Yeah, this seems like it's gonna be a fun little adventure. Dun 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 dun. I don't want to die here. All right, well, I'm gonna put these back on. Wish me luck, guys. Oh, fun. Okay. Uh-huh. Ian? Okay. Oh, that was... I was expecting a lot more. Oh, great. I see. Oh. Oh, no. I knew it! Really, guys? I can do it. Do, 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 do. Oh, ow, 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 Gosh, people try to. Gosh, trying to kill me. Please, please, trying to trap a redstoner. Gosh, gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, that's so many arrows. And there's so many more arrows in there. Oh my gosh. Alright, let's see. Is there... Oh, okay. So, yeah. If any of you haven't figured it out already, it was my good friend Echolos. Oh, that was fun. Yeah. But yeah, I've been really needing... So, apparently, Nash... Oh yeah, I've got this... It's a shulker box reader. So you can hit shift and look at the contents. And yeah, this is going to help us out a lot. I had been complaining about not having a lot of quartz for like observers and repeater or comparators. So, and then, oh my gosh, redstone. Yes. And then, thanks, Naj. I don't know how you came into this gift, but... Oh, that'll help with the project that I'm actually going to take you over and show you right now. I'm not actually sure the transition into this because I kind of recorded this. Oh my gosh. Heck. I've got arrows in my head now. But yeah, I recorded this a few days ago. So yeah, let's go over and see what I'm doing in the right up by the resource worlds in spawn. So yeah, let's get over there. As we come into spawn here, I've actually started a new project. That project is right down this way. I actually dug out the bottom of this area and prepped it for the flower forest. But then I kind of got a little carried away and yeah. So after I dug the area out, I've started putting in shakers for the flowers that are down here. And I haven't, all these have certain flowers that grow in them. I haven't put what flowers grow in them yet, but if you come up, this is a design that I made, where you just come up and you can put bone meal into this chest, and then you turn it on like this. So, okay. So this one's got oxide daisies, and it looks like a few pink tulips. So yeah, we're trying to get, me and Tech are trying to get every single flower in the flower forest. And then we're going to have these little chests here that if no one wants the flowers that or the extra flowers they were getting from this one, they can then put it into this chest and eventually this will spit out into a water stream, come over here into a sorting system over here. Maybe have all the flowers sorted on this wall. Maybe I haven't quite figured out where I'm going to have that yet, but yeah, have it sort all that out and then seeds and things like that. Or yeah, I guess it would just be seeds. Any seeds that are in there will go into a composter and be over into a bone meal stockpile over here that people can grab out of and take to each one of these. This will be a public project. We're going to be able to get free bone meal from right over here because we're right below the, not a titan, the titan that isn't quite the titan. But yeah, so we're taking all the poppies that are coming up out of this and we'll be able to divert them over to here and put them into a big storage silo for people to be able to use for bone meal for these. But I wanted to show off this design that I've been doing. I've done it the past few times, keep revising it each time. But right now I have a 7x7 area of grass up there. So we're going to take these pistons, put them on the edge. We need one layer on at least one side of this, but it kind of makes it easy to take out all of it at once. But we do that, and then we can get observers. And then, let's see, we come in here, put these observers facing where they would be facing where the observing side is away from the piston. And then we can come in here and put blocks, or any type of block. It doesn't have to be iron, but we have so much of it. I use iron. Use whatever is readily available. You can even use stone. I try to make it some kind of block that isn't used a lot. And I'm actually going to change this out and put a sea lantern on each side of this, just so we kind of get some light down here. Let's see. Yeah. All right. And then from here, we can just put blocks in front. And then grab ourselves some powered rails. And put those power rails right there. And then we actually on this side need one extra. And that will be dealt with later. I also need to take out that block. But then we do the same thing on this side. So let me just put that there. Observers all the way across this back. So for our detection on this, is actually a thing that I've done for a while, but I really haven't shown this design. But so this one, to get the timings better, you just put two observers down, a block here. Like I said, you can just put it on the stone, but if I dig into this area, I want to know, it's like, hey, iron is something you don't mess with, so I know something's there. What's up? So yeah, we'll have an observer. It's observing that block above it, and it's going into a two tick repeater into the pieces here. We'll do that same on this side, and then just for kind of to light this area up, we're going to do that. So then on this side, let's see. Actually, yeah, right there. Nope, I'm gonna have to dig down. Oh yeah, right there, and then one over block here, repeater there, and then that there for now. That needs to be two ticks also, and then do that, and then on top here we can come up, and where would that be? That's like right here, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so here we can put a dispenser, and a dispenser will normally do a three blocks in all directions from the center, so it can do a 7x7 area. This is, we're gonna get these orchids and the blue flowers. These aren't orchids, these are Lily of the Valley. The new white, where you get white bone meal, or the white dye, sorry. And then the cornflowers, of course. So from over here, we need two things in this. We need to put that there. I've got that resource pack on for that. And my son is not happy. And I need to... is not... Let's see. It's different here. Oh, I see why it's different. Okay, I got that. Gotta put this on the other side over here. So we'll break out these two blocks. And we will put this on this side then. And I'll just use that. Yeah, so with this being here, I have to put this over on this side. So we'll come over here to four hoppers there. And then right here we can put a barrel. Let's grab this barrel up here, put that there, and then to start this thing I'm going to put a note block there, and I need to get down here. Let me just grab the shovel because I'm gonna have to dig out some of this. So on this, let's say that's there. All right, So, yeah. Instead of having this on this side, I need it on the other side. Put that there, put the rail there, and then right here we're going to do a comparator, or I keep getting that wrong, it's an observer. Okay. A reserver there, repeater here, which we don't actually need on this one, but if you tile them, you need it here. So, and then we're going to do a block there, a sticky piston right here. Get rid of this block so the sticky piston can move. And then we will put that right, if I can get out of here. Let's see. Alright, let me... stone, redstone, that, and then put that there. Okay. So now, if we come over here and take out all these, and then I need to go grab some grass. That's a better thing. Alright. Now we can grab this grass and then put all this back. Put all those back down. And then we can cover this back up because we don't need it on that side. Put a couple pieces of bone meal in there. And then hit that. There we go. But yeah, that's how one of these is done. So I'm gonna finish the rest of this area up, and yeah, we'll see where we get today. So, all right, guys. So it's been a couple days, and yeah, we kind of got the top of this done. I just put in birch slabs for the ceiling, and then we have some paths around. Kind of made it all spawn proof by making it half slabs. I plan to put in some lights here, so maybe some lanterns hanging from the ceiling to make it brighter in here. But come up over here, and each one of these we put flower pots. So left to the right, left being there's more of them in this area, and right being there's less of them. So I still going to find out if I want to put a block here or what to kind of show off, how I want to show these off, but... Yeah, so each one of these is what's in this area, and you know, you just have to come down here and put in your bone meal for each one, and then yeah, turn on and off. So yeah, they're very simple and easy to use, and each one of these has it. And I think the only two I haven't done yet are over here, and it's getting late. I've got a vacation coming up soon, so I wanted to get this episode out to you. And yeah, it just keeps going. But yeah, so over here it looks like Tech already got these in. I had planned got all the materials to do it, but the way these work are the two tall flower things is got a dispenser on the bottom, a observer facing away, so it's observing it, powering the top, and then there's a piece of redstone dust on top of that. And when you do that and then have a power source on the dispenser, it observes the dispenser getting clicked. And then since there's a piece of redstone on top, it's updating the dispenser. So it's a never ending clock. So that's a really, really neat way to do it. And you can just throw some bone meal in here and then just, yeah, let it go. And it's a very, very easy way to get those dyes. So I think we still have to get all the water streams for all these double chests here to sort out. So when we get that, I think I'm going to put all the different sortable flowers on this side right here. And then maybe right over there, poke a hole back. So over there we can farm some cocoa or the cocoa beans. So yeah, guys. I think that's going to be it for me today. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving me a like and subscribe so you won't miss anything from the channel. Guys, I hope you all had a very, very Merry Christmas and, you know, coming up on a Happy New Year. Hopefully everything goes right with Kappa and I can keep making these videos for you guys. But until next time, guys, this is Indiana Light. No longer in his light skin. See you guys. Bye.